Life is a gift. I accept it. Life is an adventure. I dare. Life is a mystery. I'm unfolding it. Life is a puzzle. I'm solving it. Life is a game. I'm playing it. Life. Good evening, Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and my dear guests. I am here to share with you the art of life. But before that, I have a confession to make. I used 3 gimmicks today to capture your attention. First, I walked all the way to the corner of the room to pick up the prop. Second, I tore the prop for no reason whatsoever, just to capture your attention. And third, I modified the title of my speech. The original title of my speech was The Art of Deception. I replaced the word deception with life, which again is something I cannot be held accountable for, because the Dictionary of Oxford clearly states deception as a synonym of life. My goal today is simple. I am here to deceive you. I am here to deceive all of you into thinking that I am confident. And I guess I have succeeded until now, because I bet that at least 5 of you are going to go and check the Oxford Dictionary for the synonyms of life. Let me save you some time and effort. I was bluffed. Today, instead of looking down, I am going to stare into the abyss of your dilated pupils. Instead of hunching my shoulders and arching my back, I am going to stand upright with my chest up, my shoulders broad, and my back flat. I am going to have strong stance, great movement, and elastic expressions. I can simply complete my speech by just reading out the objectives given in my manual, like I just did. But I won't. I won't because of the morals I abide by. I am here not to deliver a speech. I am here not to deliver a project, but to complete my speech. Let me share with you a tale of my friend. His name is Rohan. He had a dog, a Pomeranian, a really cute one. His name was Snowy, I know, a generic Pomeranian name. He loved this dog. He'd run home as soon as school was over just to play with it. He'd spend more time with the dog than he ever did with us. He loved it so much that he'd not even let us pet it. One day, when Rohan was at school, his dad took the dog out for a walk. And Snowy, being the hyperactive dog he was, escaped from his owner's hands. But unfortunately, he was hit. He was hit by a car. That night, Rohan's dad did not tell him that his dog had died. He instead told him that the dog ran away. Rohan would have cried anyways. Was the father right by concealing the truth from him until later in life? Or should he have told him the truth? We are lied to on a daily basis. Throughout our childhood, we were taught that honesty is the best policy, which is ironic in itself because it is a big fat lie. As we were growing up, we learned that lying is not always bad, that a deceiver is not always a cheat, and the truth does not always result in good. Everyone lies, and there is no need to be ashamed of it. I bet to you that each and every one of you who has spoken to me before has lied to me at some point in life. Have you ever lied to me, Toastmaster Krishna? I did not lie either. I told you the truth. I told all of you the truth. I told you at the start of my speech that I was going to deceive you. That was my goal. And deceive you, I did. I deceived your emotions. The trick was simple. I initially revealed the title of my speech in order to establish a bond of trust between us. I then used 2 words, 2 simple yet powerful words. Learn and inspire to gain your sympathy. I used a device being my inability to break my morals. And all of this would have still fallen flat if not for the most important thing, the setup. I told you a tale of my friend. I made sure it was a friend and not a stranger. I made sure it was a friend with a name. I made sure that the friend's dog had a name. And I made sure that the tale was relevant to the theme, perception. But let me tell you, I have no friend named Rohan, and he had no dog. The art of deception is simple. Deception is said to be 99% truth and 1% lie. The speck that is lie is so hidden amongst the mist of truth that it's just difficult to see. We are deceived in our lives each and every day, and yet we are unaware of it. Everything is right in front of us. We fail to see it. And therein, ladies and gentlemen, lies the essence of life, the art of life, deception.